Purandaresi, what happened last time? You are so confident.
Yes, sir. Last time in interview, I got good marks like 180 above. But in my mains, I have just reduced some 10 marks near to cut out, sir.
It's an unusual problem, no? Yes, sir. A reverse problem. Okay, okay. Your hobby is organizing events for neighborhood children.
Yes, sir.
What events are you organizing?
Sir, I used to organize events like quiz competitions, sometimes to exhibit their own talents and interest, such as singing, dancing, and the role plays, what they are having in their mind, some kind of ideas to create awareness, and they have learned in their school books. These are the things I used to organize for them, sir.
You are interested in music and singing?
Yes, sir.
But have you learned anything, classical music?
Sir, so far I didn't go for any classical music classes, but I used to have the practice of singing in my house itself, and other kind of music also I used to listen, which are available in online and in other cassettes also.
But with that background, you keep on singing?
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. Foreign service not updated. Okay. Last year I had very high hopes that you will definitely get into it.
Yes,
last year when I saw you and your answers, they are very nice. Okay. Now we have this Citizenship Amendment Act.
Yes,
okay. There is protest everywhere. What is your opinion on Citizenship Amendment Act?
Sir, I think Citizenship Amendment Act really in this hour, it's really needed. But we need some more changes also, as it is just giving the minority people of these three countries like Afghan, Bangladesh and Pakistan, it can be include other people like Ahmadiyyas from Pakistan. As it based on the cultural connectivity and the historical connectivity of those region people, those who are having with India, it can be extended to them also. So I need some more changes can be make the people to feel comfort and feel and understand about the amendment really, sir.
But it doesn't violate Article 14 and 15.
Yes, sir, right to equality is there, but India is the land of the people, those who are coming here with that cultural and other related backgrounds. So as it is a motherland for all these neighboring nations, it can extend its like ability to help those people by giving them citizenship as they are living here for a long period of time.
But some eminent persecuted groups have been left out from other countries. What are they?
Sir, I think Rohingyas from Bangladesh and the Sri Lankan refugees also.
From China?
Sir, I unable to recollect the issue exactly, but it was with the Tibet during the 1970s it has happened.
The Uyghur Muslims of Xinjiang, they are also persecuted quite a lot.
Yes, sir.
Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. And what are your comments on these things?
Sir, I think we should make the policy very clear, the amendment very clear to every citizen of India that we are taken this move now. It is not simply to give them the citizenship alone. It is for our soft corner towards the people, those who are immigrated to India, and for the next generation also, because we have the real resources and more opportunities to provide them also. So I think we have to move on that way.
Okay.
Recently, Nirbhaya case was in the headlines. The punishment for people who were responsible for the rape and murder. Maybe capital punishment will be given to them. How do you look at capital punishment as a form of punishment for dispensing justice?
Sir, capital punishment, in my opinion, it can be given for the rarest of the rare case, because every punishment should be in the reformative way, but this is something, violence against women and violence against children, where the human nature itself, it's not there. It should be condemned, and the capital punishment really create deterrence in the society. So it should be there for the rarest of the rare case, I feel, sir.
In an incident in Hyderabad recently, well, maybe justice is often delayed, no? So people themselves, what shall we say, people themselves came, you know, there was an encounter, and then the people behind that incident, they were killed. Are you aware of that incident?
Yes, sir, I'm aware about that.
Yeah, how do you look at that incident? Because the issue hasn't come to the court. Well,
sir, though the issue has come to the court now, and Human Rights Commission also have taken this issue, but I feel the police officials who are involved in the investigation of this process have done their role best. Just because they were the so-called accused were in the mood to escape, this encounter action have been taken by them. So it should be done clearly through the judiciary and proper investigation more, I feel, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Purna Sundari.
Hello, sir.
So you have mentioned like Thirukkural competition from World Thirukkural Prayer Away and all, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So what is your, which is your favorite Thirukkural?
Sir, my favorite couplet comes in the chapter of Ookamudamai, that is about the energy. Ulluvadi ellam uyarvullal, matradu thallinum thallamai neerthu. It means every human being should think high, whether the aim is going to be achieved or not, but think high, work more. This is the couplet I like, sir.
Very good. So nowadays, you know, in newspapers you might have seen the ruler, some people they put like the ruler in kavi dress and other things. So what is your opinion on that?
Sir, this is really unfortunate, and it should be avoided. Because of some politicization, people, those who are really unaware about the value of poet Thiruvalluvar and the couplets he has given to the world, the whole human society, it has been done in this way. But it should be made clear, this kind of action should not be continued hereafter. So the investigation and people, how they should respect the poets and the literature of Tamil in the further manner should be taught by the officials, I feel, sir.
So in last couple of weeks, we heard about this 5th standard and 8th standard exam.
Yes, sir.
Right. Is it necessary for this 5th standard and 8th standard public exam for the school kids in Tamil Nadu?
Sir, I don't think the 5th standard and 8th standard students should be given with public exams, because exams are something which really creates the fear among the students nowadays. It can be there for the 10th and plus 2 level exams, but to test the quality of the children of their standards can be done by the other school's question papers, other school teachers. It can be done through that manner, really check the quality and bring out the value of the education of that particular institute, sir, rather for going for public exams for these small children.
Already the common might have been discussed all these things with other, you know, a lot of educationalists are there, people are there in Tamil Nadu particularly. So what way, you know, they can, like, you know, go about it, or like they can convince it?
Sir, instead of going for public exams, we may say district level exams for the 8th standard students, as they are in the 13-14 age group. But for the small children like 10 year age group who are in the 5th standard, can be deal with other schools. In the particular district, they may have particular zone, so that their educational background, extracurricular activities, both can be taken into account. They will be just test those things. With the association of teachers and parents, we may make this point clear to the officials also, sir.
So you are from Madurai, right?
Yes, sir.
What is the unique thing in Madurai?
Sir, Madurai is famous for its culture. It is known as Temple City and also for jasmine flower. Sorry, sir. Purna Sundari.
Purna Sundari. What is the meaning of your name?
Sir, Purna means complete, fulfillment, and Sundari means beauty.
Regarding this PIA protest,
yes,
most of the places women are leading the struggles. Why?
Sir, can I have the question once again, please?
In most of the places,
yes,
people are protesting against this.
Yes.
In most of the places, women are leading that protest marches. They are participating in a huge number.
Yes.
In certain places, they only stage the protest. This is a new development in our democracy. Why?
Sir, as India is in the transition mode, in every issues, women involvement is really high. It's really huge in number. More number of women are coming forward and protesting. Even in this issue, as people have felt that right to equality is really affected, more number of women, as they are from some other minority group, they do feel that their rights of having employment opportunity, education for their children, everything can be affected in some time. Because of that lack of awareness and the rights, they really don't want to just to give, not they are coming and protesting now, sir.
Police is handling them in a brutal way. We can describe like that. What do you
think? Sir, I see this. It is happening even in some corner, some pockets of India, because in most of the areas, people are just damaging the public like amenities, what they are available with, like the buses and other institutions. But treating them brutally, it should be avoided. So nowadays, the online medias like WhatsApp and other things are really portraying through the videos they have taken. So that is transparency. If they are really involved in some kind of actions that is treating them brutally, it should be awarded and it should be bring out to the judiciary, and proper investigation should be done. Sir.
What is the aim of our jurisprudence? Affirming or retribution?
Sir, I would say it should reform on the basis because more number of people are involving in crimes and they are really going against some kind of initiatives and other policies taken by the government for the money. So it should be on the reformative basis. So the proper way of thinking and giving them counseling will work out more, I think.
Have you ever come across the JJ Act?
I'm sorry, sir, I'm unable to recall about it.
It is Juvenile Justice Care and Protection Act.
Yes, sir, thank you for the information.
It is revoked in Uttar Pradesh. The protesters are protesters brought their children to the protest. So children participating in the protest is against their interest. And the government is revoking that and filed cases against women or their parents. What do you think of it?
Sir, I think it should be go for the reconsideration, because children at this very young age, they will follow automatically what their parents are telling to them, what way they are guiding. So it should be go for the reconsideration, and children should not be affected for the actions of what the parents or their guardians are taking. It will lead to some kind of misuse of these small children. Also, it also affects the future of those children, sir. So it should be avoided, I feel.
Yes, you are working in Tamnad Gramin Bank.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell us, in shorter words, the functioning of the Gramin Bank and what it is and what is that and outlay and other things?
Sure, sir. Sir, Tamil Nadu Grama Bank, it is newly emerged in the year of 2019 April. Earlier, it was like Pandian and Pallavan Gramin Bank in Tamil Nadu. The main function is giving attention to the rural and suburban areas where we are having more number of agrarian based workers, the farmers and the self-help groups like women. So these people are really given attention, and for having deposits like recurring deposits and fixed deposits from them, giving them the joint loan and other manufacturing SME loans are being done clearly by the help of these Tamil Nadu Grama Banks.
Is it true that the Indian banking is undergoing a crisis? If it is so, could you please explain us in simple terms?
Yes, sir. Really, now the banking system, Indian banking system is in the crisis because of the bad loans and the NPA. Nowadays, the willful defaulters and the economy have changed the plot of the loanees who have taken loans from these banks, sir. So, the recapitalization of the government and strengthening the economy by reducing repo rates and other investment policies like single window clearance for the SMEs, really helping the people to come forward and have better access with formal financial institutions like banks. So the banks ultimately having know about these areas where they have to invest, give advances for the people, and they are they can function better also. The merge merging of these banks like Pandian and Pallavan really enhanced the administration and attention for the areas, particularly for the demand of those areas. If it is in the Kanyakumari, the district located in the southern part of Tamil Nadu, where the fishermen have been given much attention, sir, those kind of schemes also included in this bank now. So it will make more access to the bank, as well as it really helps the bank to make the finance stable, bring financial stability, sir.
So who is responsible for the bad loans,
sir?
Is it the system, the RBI, individual nationalized big banks like the State Bank of India, etc., etc., or the rulers, the political class as such, responsible for the bad loans and the NPA?
Sir, I'll go for both. First of all, the customers, when they ask for loan, because of lack of transparency and the inclusiveness of data in what are the banks they have taken already the advance, now it has been developed, the system is being developed now, so we could know he is willful defaulter already. But earlier, because of lack of information sharing, it has happened. On the other hand, the managers of the branches are also should know in what are the areas they could give advance, so that the society and the people can get benefit of it. The bank financial stability or also will be there. So it is the lack of these two areas, I feel so.
Can we name and shame the defaulters?
Sir, so far I could recollect the huge willful defaulters like Nirav Modi and Vijay Mallya, who were just gone off that time, sir.
What about Chandra Kochar?
Yes, sir.
You agree with that?
Sir, actually it was the conflict of interest. So the proper investigation can be done. Out of that, we can come to the conclusion, I feel so.
Is it worthwhile considering that the time has come now to reconsider the nationalization of banks?
Certainly, yes, sir, because after nationalizing the banks in 1960s, more number of banks are there, because earlier, because of the private banks alone, customers felt the insolvency, and bankruptcy also happened huge in number. Now it has been reduced and it has been regulated by the central bank RBI with proper guidance, and NABARD also on the other hand regulating the banks like Grameen Bank. So there is stability, and nationalization really helped a lot, sir.
Okay. So when I asked you about Citizenship Act, yes, and Article 14-15, you have used the word citizenship 2-3 times. Actually, Article 14 is not meant for citizens, meant for all persons.
All persons. Thank you.
So they will be given citizenship. Okay, so only after that they become citizens. So read about little more, because that is a major bonding issue these days. Little more. I didn't go to the depth of it. I'll ask other questions, which others have to ask, but read about it. Okay.
Sure, sir.
Things are all right. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.